Now students, as you are aware what a symmetric and a skew symmetric matrix is, let us discuss some theorems related to it. As you can see, the first theorem states, for any square matrix with real number entries, the sum of A and A transpose will be a symmetric and the difference of A and A transpose will be a skew symmetric matrix. Let us see how it can be obtained. Let us assume A to be B to be a matrix which is denoting A plus A transpose. So evaluating for B transpose, which can be written as transpose of A plus A transpose. Now going by the properties which we discussed in the previous video, it says A plus A transpose whole transpose can be written as transpose of first matrix plus transpose of second. So A transpose plus transpose of A transpose can be written as A, this is the other property which we discussed on transpose of matrices. So you can see transpose of B is coming out to be sum of A transpose plus A, which is nothing but the matrix B itself. So finally we saw that B transpose is equal to B. That means the matrix B, which is A plus A transpose, is symmetric. In the same way, if we assume C to be another matrix which is denoting A minus A transpose, and then taking transpose of the matrices on both the sides, we get C transpose as transpose of A minus A transpose. Again, using the properties of transpose of a matrix, C transpose can also be written as A transpose minus transpose of A transpose. So this A transpose as it is, but transpose of A transpose, as we know, can be written as A. Now this is not equal to C, but if I take a minus sign common, the expression in the bracket reduces to A minus A transpose, which is denoting the matrix C. So we see that C transpose is coming out to be minus C. So C is actually denoting a skew symmetric matrix. That means C, which is A minus A transpose, is a skew symmetric matrix. And B is a symmetric matrix. So now we know that sum of a matrix with its transpose will be symmetric, difference of a matrix and its transpose will be skew symmetric. This is what we are going to use in the second theorem. So coming to the next theorem, which states that every square matrix or any square matrix can be represented as the sum of symmetric or skew symmetric matrix. So any matrix, any square matrix can be expressed as a sum of symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. Let us prove it. Suppose A is a square matrix . Then we can even write A as half of twice of A. This is how A can be written. Further, twice of A can be expressed as sum of A and A. Now in this sum, we can add A transpose and we can subtract A transpose. If we simplify this, this will again reduce to A only. So now I have written A as half of sum of A plus A transpose and A minus A transpose. Further, the expression can be written as half of A plus A transpose and half of A minus A transpose. So you can see I have broken A into two matrices. The first part is denoting half of A plus A transpose and the other one is denoting as half of A minus A transpose. So A is expressed as a sum of two matrices. And if you go by the previous theorem, we know A plus A transpose is symmetric, A minus A transpose is symmetric. So over here, 1 by 2 A plus A transpose is a symmetric matrix, and half of A minus A transpose is a skew symmetric matrix. So you can see any square matrix which you are having can be expressed as a sum of symmetric and a skew symmetric matrices.